Good morning students, welcome back in fourth session. In previous session, we have seen processing data and output devices. In today's session, we will see storing data, memory, parts of memory and how to shut down the computer. First of all, we see storing data. Computers can store a large amount of data, but where does it all go? Let us learn more about it. Memory. So what is a memory? A computer has a part where it stores all the information and data. This part of the computer is called memory. The lessons you learn at school are stored in your brain. In the same way, the computer too has a part where it stores all the information and data. This part of the computer is called a memory. You can access this memory and refer to the information stored in it. The information in the memory can be changed or erased too. So, there are two main parts of the memory in a computer. The first one is primary memory, is also called a main memory, and the secondary memory. Students, I am sharing a video to learn about memory and storing data in brief.
Memory and storage of a computer. Hello friends, I am sure you were very excited during your last birthday party and you definitely remember all the details related to that birthday party. Have you ever thought how you were able to recall the details of any particular event like your birthday party? All the things we are able to remember in our daily life come from our memories. Whenever we need to recall any detail, we can just think and remember things from our memory. In the same way, a computer also has a memory. Whenever we need any information from the computer, we can get it from its memory. We use different storage places to keep our things safe. When you go to school, your mother packs some food for you. Where does she keep the food? Yes, in the lunch box. So the lunch box is a place for storage of food. When you want to keep your clothes, where do you keep them? Or where will you keep your toys once you have finished playing? You use an almirah or cupboard for storing your clothes and toys to keep them safe. So, almirah is the storage place for your clothes and toys. Similarly, you store pencils, eraser and sharpener in a pencil box. So, pencil box is the storage place for your pencils, eraser and sharpener. You carry your books in your school bag. So, school bag is the storage place for our books and notebooks. A computer needs to store a lot of information so that it can perform many different functions. Hence, storage of information is very necessary for a computer. This information is stored in the computer memory and in special storage devices like hard disk. A computer can store files, images, videos, songs, movies, games, etc. in its memory. Some of the storage places used by computers are hard disk, memory card, CDs and DVDs, floppy and pen drive. Do you remember what you ate for breakfast on this day last year? Or when did you attend school for the first time? Definitely not, because sometimes we can forget a lot of things and it's not possible for us to recall that particular moment. But once an information is stored in the memory of a computer, it never gets erased from the computer memory unless and until we have not deleted it from our end.
Main memory. So what is a main memory? Main memory is what the computer uses when it is open. The main storage region of a computer to which the central processor has immediate or direct access. When you open a file, a folder or a program, the computer places it in main memory. When you create a new file or make changes to an open file, the CPU requests information it needs from main memory. It then makes changes as per the commands you input and sends the modified data back to main memory. Now, if you do not save this file and switch off the computer, all the changes you made will be lost. This is because main memory does not hold data after the computer is switched off. Students, now I am sharing a video to learn more about main memory.
Computers never forget once the information is stored. A computer has two types of memory. Primary memory, secondary memory. Primary memory. Every computer comes with a certain amount of primary memory or main memory. This memory is limited and information stored in this memory gets erased when you turn off the computer. This is internal memory that is constantly overwritten with new data and programs for quick access. It provides temporary storage of small-sized data.
Our next memory is secondary memory. So what is a secondary memory? A secondary memory is where programs and data are kept on a long-term basis. Common secondary storage devices are floppy disk, CD, pen drive. If you give the command to save a file, the file will be stored in secondary memory. This is usually a hard disk placed inside the cabinet containing the CPU. The next time you switch the computer on, you will be able to open the saved file again. You can also store data on floppy disks, pen drives, CDs, and the DVDs, which are also called the secondary storage device. Now, watch the video for to get more information about secondary memory.
Secondary memory. Only primary memory does not serve our purpose. We require to store a large amount of data permanently. For this purpose, secondary memory or storage devices are used. More and more storage devices can be used to store unlimited volume of data. Storage devices. Nowadays, high capacity storage devices are available. A hard disk can store from 120 GB or GB to 2 TB or TB or more. In this chapter, we will learn about the external memory or secondary memory, commonly known as storage devices. Storage devices provide a location where data can be stored when it is not being processed. A computer can read and input data from storage devices for further processing. And at the same time, it can store processed information onto these devices again and again. Primary memory is small in size, but faster than secondary memory. When we work on our computer, the work is saved on primary memory.
Here, we come to the end of this session. In the next session, we will learn how to shut down a computer and start solving the exercise. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.